So here's something that's been on my mind, right? In 2008, we had a lot of fantastic movies. Not like, oh, it snubbed an Oscar nom and then we like never talk about it again, but films that a decade later are still talked about excessively. And yet, there's another little film that I still think about to this day, and it's something that didn't get swarmed with a lot of attention, not this crazy Oscar buzz, but it's a movie called Dear Zachary, and it's a documentary. Look, if there's, I know I'm not the only one in saying this, that, you know, growing up with films and loving narratives, you kind of like ignore documentaries, right? Like, I know I'm not the only one, and I've changed over the years, but at the same time, right? I know a lot of people think of documentaries as being those things that your high school history teacher rolls out with that Zenith TV that's got the dusty VHS tapes and it takes like 3 hours to get through. But not all docs are like that. Like, I know that it's kind of become like a genre. People see documentaries as a genre, but really they can be comedies, they can be thrillers, they can be dramas, they can be super delicious, and they can undoubtedly make you cry by the end of it. And I'm being completely serious, I'm not gonna spoil this. Go watch Dear Zachary and go watch The Imposter, because those are both fantastic movies that, even though they're documentaries, the point that I'm trying to make is that for those who haven't opened themselves up to this world, documentaries aren't boring anymore. So of course, being from Chicago, I wanted to highlight the Doc10 Film Festival that I'll be attending. For those of you Chicago nights, I may be seeing you there. For the rest of you, I hope you like these recommendations, because these are recommendations that not only have gone from Sundance, but have gone to this festival right here. And this festival has people who produce Oscar-winning films like Icarus, which won the Oscar just this past year. So I'm going to break down the three documentaries that are not only going to be at the festival, but the documentaries that are the highlights for me of the year thus far, and also cover the one that I'll be seeing there at the festival, the one about Mr. Rogers, which, if you've seen that trailer, and you don't have any emotions from that, you have less feelings than Aubrey Plaza. So for starters, there's a documentary called 306 Hollywood. And I remember seeing a teaser for this back at Sundance, where I thought it looked like Wes Anderson doing a home video about his grandma. Pretty much, it's about these two grandkids who started documenting their grandma. And when she passed, they had to dig through all of her house. At first, you get some vibes like it's going to be like Gone Home-ish, but you know, the grandma doesn't end up being like a Jewish spy or anything. But it is one of those stories where it's all about, once you're gone, everything you leave behind is what defines you, right? So you start thinking about like, well, what the heck am I leaving behind, right? And even more of a deeper question that they pose to you is, it's not just what you leave behind, but who's going to be there to archive it for you? That's why I make these videos right here on YouTube, and that way I will be remembered forever until Skynet comes in and destroys everything. RBG was the next one, which for me is the perfect example of highlighting someone who you don't know much about, but documentaries can like open up that world for you. Like, I knew her from the whole I dissent memes that were going around, but I did not know this woman was a savage. It's about Justice Ruth Bader Ginsburg and all the things that she did for women's equality and for minorities and how she actually got stuff done. Like, there's a point where they show this montage of how she was taking on cases, right, in order to prove something in this case that would then have those people looking dumb when she brought up this other case. Like, she was using cases to win other cases. She was playing chess when everyone else was playing checkers. That's why they call her the notorious RBG. Crime and Punishment, for me, I believe, was the most impactful one. Like, I know that there's been this whole, you know, Black Lives, Blue Lives thing. This movie just takes it, right? And looks at the cops who are trying to do good and they can't. And again, I like my documentaries when they're like super gritty. When you start seeing like 240p YouTube footage, because everything's unraveling in real time, right? Like, you're watching these people through like hidden cameras. You're seeing actual facts stated that show you the corruption that's going on in New York City. You're following police officers who might not have a job by the time the credits roll in this movie. And this guy right here, this guy goes through something in this movie in the cold that's gonna heat you up. Of course, there's then the Mr. Rogers documentary. I have not seen this one, but I will be seeing this one at the Doc10 Film Festival. And just by the trailer alone, thing looks insane. And the thing is that for me, like, Mr. Rogers is like the OG. Like, with everything, all the scandals, everything that's coming out, I know there's been that this one like Twitter quote about that if he even has like overdue library fines, then that alone will break your heart, because this guy, like, there's so much about him. Back in high school, my buddy and I, literally, I kid you not, we got cardigans just in honor of Mr. Rogers. Like, that's how cool we thought he was. So I've had this thing for, like, years. Point being that I'm super stoked to watch this movie because, you know, he's been pushing that peace, love, and positivity way before Logic. And if you want to see this movie, you can see it with me. We can meet up if you're from Chicago by heading over to the Doc10 Film Festival. This movie in particular is going to be playing opening night, April 5th at 7 p.m. at the Davis Theater in Chicago. So if you want to head out and watch that movie, I'll be there Thursday night. We can meet and greet, tweet me, DM me, however we can meet up. And if you're from out of town and you end up flying in for the festival, I'll cover your coffee. But the point of the festival and the point of this video is to do just that. Push documentaries. Show you that documentaries don't have that stigma anymore. They're no longer boring. There's good editing. There's crazy storytelling going on. There's impactful things because we go to movies, right? Fictional narratives to see something and feel something that's really just trying to replicate real life. These movies are real life. If you trust my opinion, catch these right here. If you really trust my opinion, go back and watch these right here. And if you want to meet up, like I said, meet me at the Doc10 Film Festival. And if you're watching in the future, then I'll see you in next year's.